Soccer is very fast-paced, and it's pretty physical, especially playing in the Big Ten. That's just kind of the style of play, is pretty physical.
It was always kind of interesting to kind of think about potential injuries, potential problems with soccer. And there was a moment, I think particularly in his high school years, where concussions became a really big topic.
You do think about protecting your body a little bit, I think, just naturally. When you're in practice and stuff, there's times that coaches and even yourself, you're like, I don't want to take this ball to the head. And then in the game, you might have to sacrifice a little bit more, and it's more expected.
People think of soccer as kind of a non-contact sport, which is kind of interesting, because I think it's a contact sport. It's not a collision sport like football, but it's a contact.
I think it's really important to have both women and men equally tested. In diving, it's kind of hard to notice when those things happen, like concussions, just because to some people who don't really know the sport, you know, it could just look like a normal dive. But, you know, to us, we know when it feels like wrong, the way we go in the water.
The awareness has increased dramatically, but the science hasn't kept up with the awareness. So we're really just at the very beginning stages in many ways of understanding what concussion means.
The CARE Consortium right now is the largest concussion study taking place currently at the collegiate level.
Roughly speaking, 90% of people with a concussion will spontaneously heal in something like 12 to 14 days. And the CARE Consortium has provided the best numbers to date for how long you would expect someone to need to recover before they can start the return to play protocol.
It's a collaboration that I have rarely seen. The NCAA and DOD are jointly funding a study. So you have 30 NCAA member schools, including 4 service academies.
What we're doing is collecting all of this baseline data and assessments, as well as post-injury testing. We upload into a online database, and what we're attempting to do is to try and help improve overall concussion care and recovery for our student athletes and cadets.
There's this 10% that remain that take much longer to recover, and those are clinically who we worry about the most.
We're attempting to assess each student athlete multidimensionally. So we're looking at cognitive functions. So as soon as a student athlete arrives to campus, before contact practice, we test all student athletes. We'll compare that to any post-injury testing that we may perform if a student athlete is suspected of having a concussion, which helps us to formulate our diagnosis.
We've already now studied over 30,000 athletes and military cadets, servicemen and women combined.
The eye movement study is very singularly focused on seeing if we can use the involuntary aspects of eye movements to diagnose concussions on the sidelines. So it was a very focused study to just look at one thing. Could we develop a better sideline test that would be something that would be cheap and affordable for athletic trainers and team physicians around the world to add to their toolkit?
I think one thing is going to lead to another. You'll have one data paper that's going to come out, and that's going to lead to a sub-analysis. So this is going to be the beginning. Probably over the next 6 to 12 months is going to be the sort of the first trickle of the data. And then over the next 2 years, I think there's going to be an enormous release of data.
There are risks involved with concussions, and there's especially risks if you have multiple concussions too close together. So we learned that we could do a better job, and we are doing a better job, but that we shouldn't stop. We should keep learning more about concussions through concussion research, through projects like the NCAA DOD CARE.
Soccer is probably a small window in Jeremiah's life, and he has a lot of life after.
Looking down the road in 20 years, I probably won't be playing soccer. I kind of hope I'm not running that hard in 20 years, but I'll be doing something else that I'm hopefully just as passionate about.
What I want him to do is be in a position to pursue what he wants to pursue after soccer with the same kind of passion that he's put into soccer. I don't want brain injuries to get in the way of that kind of pursuit.